We're in northern France for the 13th World University Rowing Championships. The second time France has played host, but it's the first global event for the Gravelines Basin here, handily located near the border. I think that actually it's one of our assets to be located where we are, here, as close as we are to those countries with a strong tradition in rowing. Germany, England, Belgium, and slightly less Holland as well. Those are countries with a strong tradition in rowing. And word from the Sports International Federation. We all know how important our sport is for the academic community. It should be noted that in many countries there are many rowers in universities. It's a universal sport par excellence. So, for the International Rowing Federation, it's very important to support what's going on here. 34 nations are taking part in the championships with nearly 500 athletes, a record. They've come from every continent, among them first-time countries like Morocco and Sri Lanka.
In our country, we started rowing after entering into our university. But here, most of the people have started rowing in their schools.
In childhood,
and
they
yeah, they have been rowing for 6-7 years. And in our case, it's around 2 years. And it's kind of experiencing is also playing here. And that's the thing. They have more experience and they use these conditions as and there are the problems here.
13 competitions are on the program. The sculls, single, double and quadruple, where each rower has 2 oars, and 3 disciplines where the rowers have just 1 oar apiece, the eights and the cockless pairs and fours. The championships bring together many of the best rowers on the planet, like Simon Baylor, the Hungarian, who competed at the London Olympic Games.
Olympic is the highest level, so the university rowing is a little bit easier, but not easy. The pressure is always the same because we need to do 2,000 meters, so only the maximum. There are a lot of elite level of rowers, so near the same.
Eva Kapanen in the Finnish team carries the pressure of her father's name. Pertti Kapanen was a triple Olympic champion, one of the biggest names in world rowing.
I don't think it's that, because it's just my father. He's my father, not a great rower for me. Of course, I know that he used to be a great rower, and that's really good. But first of all, he's just my father. He said, just go hard and have fun. Enjoy the day, yeah.
As always, one country is under extra pressure in the World Championships, the organizing country. In this case, France. Our first goal was to get our 7 boats here into the finals, so we've done the first part of our work. Secondly, we have to set an example because we're the host country. And then we've got the advantage of knowing the site. We've been able to row at a preview training camp before these World Championships, and so we've put ourselves in the best position to produce the best possible performance. Qualifying for the coxless fours, the Sri Lankans are up against the Russians, the Czechs, the Dutch, and the Chinese. That's tough.
In our country, we mostly use crocodiles. So basically, this is different from us. So it's difficult for us to balance the boat.
Yeah.
Because the water doesn't grip properly. So we did improve. We rowed for like 3 days before, like 3 sessions before the regatta. We had a bit of time, but I don't think it was enough for us to adapt for this equipment.
Eva Kapanen is a specialist in the double sculls, but here she's competing in the singles, where her father made his name. Eva got through to the final, but she finishes behind Germany's Marie-Catherine Arnold.
I pushed a bit too windy for me. I had 20 times in a single this year, so... But yeah, I'm happy that I was in the final. The final could have been a lot better.
In the men's cockless pairs, the race is between Hungary and South Africa. The Hungarians tapping into their reserves to resist their main rivals. Simon Baylor is the university world champion.
In a sportsman's life, is one of the most important is the Olympic Games, but the same important is the medals from other very big races, so it's wonderful. It's one of the best feeling if I dream ever, so it's very good. It was a good race, very, very strong and good opponent, so it's wonderful.
13 competitions, 9 British boats in the finals, and 4 victories so far. Great Britain remains a formidable power in the world of rowing, and the eights is the blue-ribboned event of these championships. It's the boat that's used in the most famous race in the world, Oxford against Cambridge, won 3 times by Carl Hudspeth.
They're very different races, the Oxford-Cambridge boat race and the FISU World Championships. The boat race is a long 4-mile race on a bendy river, and it's just a one-on-one race. Whereas out here, it's a 2K sprint, and it's a multi-lane regatta, so we've got 6 crews in the final. It makes it a lot faster, a lot more furious. You've got to just go out as hard as you can and keep on going.
Up against Great Britain here, the strong eights of France and Canada. They will push the British to their limits. The final is tight all the way, but the British finally win.
It's a great event, and I'm very pleased to have won it. It's actually my second time at FISU, and it's also my second gold medal. I'm very proud to be a champion at this event.
Behind Great Britain, France has achieved its goals. The balance sheet is more than positive. We have a new world title in the Coxless Fours in the lightweight division. It was expected a little bit, but until they crossed the line, it was still a bit uncertain. The women's four, that was gorgeous. Nothing else to say about it. And then the eight finishing second behind the British boat. That, I think, well, we're not yet able to go and beat them. But we'll see you at the Universiade in Guangzhou, and we'll see what happens. I hope we can take a delegation as complete and competitive as this one, because, well, these guys deserve it. The next rowing university championships will be in Poznan in Poland in 2016.
When education meets sport and culture, what best promotes excellence in mind and body? Where do friendship, integrity, and achievement meet? Which event gathers the best student athletes from around the world? The Universiade, the home of international university sports. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.